فاشرف بي لاشتغالي بالعلم ولا تبغي به ما عشت يا ذا بدلا ويا له من شرف عظيم.
الحمد لله رب العالمين، والصلاة والسلام على أشرف الأنبياء والمرسلين سيدنا ونبينا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين، أما بعد. وهنا وكتاب ثلاثة الأصول. This is the seventh lesson إن شاء الله تعالى. We stopped at the point where the Shaykh rahimahullah, he said الرابعة الصبر على الأذى فيه. The author rahimahullah, he spoke about knowledge, and then he spoke about implementing that knowledge, and then he spoke about calling to that knowledge, and the fourth point, which is the مسألة الرابعة, the fourth point, the fourth matter, which is الصبر, to be patient, على الأذى فيه, the harm that occurs after the person has learned and has studied and he has implemented the knowledge in which he has learned, and then he goes out to call the people to it, he should be patient. Because from the sunnah of Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, from the way Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala controls matters, is that he made the prophets and those who follow the prophets. And جعل الأنبياء والمرسلين الذين هم أفضل الخلق وأعلاهم درجة. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he has made the scholars and the prophets أشد الناس ابتلاء وتعرضا للأذى. He has made them the people who suffer the most and who encounter harm. And the prophets and the messengers and those who follow them, فصبروا على الإعراض عنهم, they become patient in the harm that they encounter. ولذلك الله سبحانه وتعالى said in the Quran, فاصبر, be patient, كما صبر أولو العزم من الرسل ولا تستعجل لهم. Be patient like the أولو العزم, were patient from the messengers, ولا تستعجل لهم, and do not hasten. The أولو العزم are five chosen prophets. It is Nabiullah Nuh, Ibrahim, Musa, Isa, and Nabiullah Muhammad. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded them in that ayah to our Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Allah commanded him to be patient like those prophets were patient. Patience is an objective and a goal that whoever realizes the importance, who understands its value, will want to come with and attain it. ولذلك the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in the hadith Imam al-Bukhari narrated in his Sahih on the authority of Khabbab ibn al-Arat radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, وَاللَّهِ لَيُتِمَّنَّ هَذَا الْأَمْرَ حَتَّى يَسِيرَ الرَّاكِبُ مِنْ صَنْعَاءَ إِلَى حَذْرَ مَوْتَ لَا يَخَافُ إِلَّا اللَّهِ وَالذِّئْبَ عَلَى غَنَمِهِ وَلَكِنَّكُمْ تَسْتَعْجِلُونَ. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, Allah is going to complete and establish this matter until a traveler comes from Sana'a, which is a place in Yemen, and he goes to Hadramaut, which is another place in Yemen. He travels that distance. He doesn't fear except Allah. لا يخاف إلا الله والذئب على غنمه. And he fears a wolf for his herd of sheep and goats and lamb. ولكنكم تستعجلون, but you are hasty. This is going to come a time when safety encompasses the Muslims. But the Prophet is saying to the companion, you are hasty. You're not coming with the patience that is needed. So that hadith goes hand in hand with the ayah in Surah Al-Ahqaf, ayah 35. فَاصْبِرْ كَمَا صَبَرَ أُولُو الْعَزْمِ مِنَ الرُّسُلِ وَلَا تَسْتَعْجِلْ لَهُمْ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He has honored, وَقَدْ شَرَّفَ اللَّهُ أَهْلَ الصَّبْرِ. Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, He has honored the people of patience. وَأَكْرَمَهُمْ فَجَعَلَهُمْ فِي مَعِيَّتِهِ. And Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, He placed them by making those who He is with. And whoever Allah tabarak wa ta'ala is with, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala protects him. And what is more greater than that? قَالَ تَعَالَى, Allah says, إِنَّ اللَّهَ مَعَ الصَّابِرِينَ, Allah is with those who are patient. Allah tabarak wa ta'ala also says, وَاصْبِرُوا إِنَّ اللَّهَ مَعَ الصَّابِرِينَ, be patient, Allah is with those who are patient. وَالْمَعِيَّةُ نَوْعَانَ, Allah being with is of two types. معية عامة, a general معية, and a معية خاصة, and a specific type of it. And the معية here that is meant is المعية الخاصة. المعية الخاصة means that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is with you by giving you victory and aid. وهي معية النصر والمدد والتأييد والفضل. It means Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is with you to give you victory, to aid you, to support you, and to bestow His virtue unto you. As for the general type of ma'iyah, it means Allah is with you by way of knowledge, and He knows what you're doing, and He's encompassed your actions and everything you are thinking. And that is the one that is in Surah Al-Hadid, وَهُوَ مَعَكُمْ أَيْنَمَا كُنْتُمْ, Allah is with all of you wherever you are, by knowledge. So that's for the believer and the disbeliever. But this one, which is الْمَعِيَّةُ الْخَاصَّةُ, is for the one who is patient. The second type of virtue that comes to the one who is patient is, or that indicates the virtue of patience, is that Allah tabarak wa ta'ala loves those who are patient. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He said, وَاللَّهُ يُحِبُّ الصَّابِرِينَ, Allah loves those who are patient. So now you've gained Allah being with you. You've also gained Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala loving you. So the question is, فَإِن كُنْتَ أَيُّهَا الصَّابِرُ, O you who is patient, if Allah tabarak wa ta'ala is with you, فَمِمَّنْ تَخَافُ, who are you scared of? And if Allah tabarak wa ta'ala loves you, وَإِن كَانَ اللَّهُ يُحِبُّكَ, if Allah loves you, فَعَلَى أَيِّ شَيْءٍ تَحْزَنْ, then why are you depressed and why are you stressed? Because the truth of the matter is that patience is جَوَّادٌ لَا يَكْبُو وَجُنْدٌ لَا يُهْزَمْ وَحِصْنٌ لَا يُهْدَمْ. Patience gains those virtues that the Prophet and Allah tabarak wa ta'ala gave it. The third virtue, or the third evidence that has come through the Kitab and the Sunnah to elaborate on the virtue of patience is that the people who are patient are the people who have conviction. They are the people who are determined. And determination is for those people. أهل الصبر هم أهل العزائم. And Allah said that in the Quran, سبحانه وتعالى. وَلَمَنْ صَبَرَ وَغَفَرَ إِنَّ ذَٰلِكَ لَمِنْ عَزْمِ الْأُمُورِ. The one who is patient and the one who forgives, then verily that is from the most determined of affairs. In another place Allah says, وَإِنْ تَصْبِرُوا وَتَتَّقُوا فَإِنَّ ذَٰلِكَ مِنْ عَزْمِ الْأُمُورِ. وَقَالَ تَعَالَى, Allah also says, وَأْمُرْ بِالْمَعْرُوفِ وَانْهَ عَنِ الْمُنْكَرِ وَاصْبِرْ عَلَى مَا أَصَابَكَ إِنَّ ذَٰلِكَ مِنْ عَزْمِ الْأُمُورِ. The first ayah was in Surah Al-Shura, ayah 43. The second was Surah Ali Imran, ayah 186. And the third one is Surah Al-Luqman, ayah 17. All of those verses, Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala is affirming these characteristics of Al-Azaim, determination and unwavering conviction is for those people who are patient. Also, from the virtue is Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala, He compiled and He has affirmed glad tidings after glad tidings after glad tidings for the people who are patient. Glad tidings are for the people who are patient. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He said in Surah Al-Baqarah, ayah 155, وَلَنَبْلُوَنَّكُمْ بِشَيْءٍ مِّنَ الْخَوْفِ وَالْجُوعِ وَنَقْصٍ مِّنَ الْأَمْوَالِ وَالْأَنفُسِ وَالثَّمَرَاتِ وَبَشِّرِ الصَّابِرِينَ. Give glad tidings to the people who are patient. Allah also says to us, who are those who are patient? What does it mean to be patient? The ayah after Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala says, وَبَشِّرِ الصَّابِرِينَ الَّذِينَ إِذَا أَصَابَتْهُمْ مُصِيبَةٌ قَالُوا إِنَّا لِلَّهِ وَإِنَّا إِلَيْهِ رَاجِعُونَ. Look at this virtue that is mentioned for them. أُولَٰئِكَ عَلَيْهِمْ صَلَوَاتٌ مِّن رَبِّهِمْ وَرَحْمَةٌ وَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْمُهْتَدُونَ. Upon them is salutation from their Lord and mercy. And verily they are the guided ones. These are all the glad tidings that are being mentioned for them. What are those glad tidings? صَلَوَاتٌ مِّن رَبِّهِمْ, salutations from their Lord. وَرَحْمَةٌ, and a mercy. And guidance has been affirmed for them. The fifth virtue of patience is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He clarifies to us and tells us the honor of the people of patience. When the angels enter onto them to give them the glad tidings of Jannah and to greet them with this noble greeting, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He said, وَالْمَلَائِكَةُ يَدْخُلُونَ عَلَيْهِمْ مِنْ كُلِّ بَابٍ. The angels will be entering onto them from every door. سَلَامٌ عَلَيْكُمْ بِمَا صَبَرْتُمْ. Peace be upon you for being patient. فَنِعْمَ عُقُبَ الدَّارِ. Blessed is the final ending of where you are residing. Patience, my brothers and sisters, is the characteristics of the prophets and the righteous people. It's the characteristics you find in them. فَاصْبِرْ كَمَا صَبَرَ أُولُو الْعَزْمِ مِنَ الرُّسُلِ وَلَا تَسْتَعْجِلْ لَهُمْ. As I mentioned before in Surah Al-Rum, ayah 60. And in Surah Al-Ahqaf, ayah 35. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He said, وَإِسْمَاعِيلَ وَإِدْرِيسَ وَذَا الْكِفْلِ كُلٌّ مِّنَ الصَّابِرِينَ وَأَدْخَلْنَاهُمْ فِي رَحْمَتِنَا إِنَّهُمْ مِّنَ الصَّالِحِينَ. Ismail and Idris and Al-Kifl, all of them are from the patient ones. And Allah says, وَأَدْخَلْنَاهُمْ فِي رَحْمَتِنَا, we entered our mercy onto them. إِنَّهُمْ مِنَ الصَّالِحِينَ, verily they are from the righteous ones. Also Allah said, وَلَقَدْ كُذِّبَتْ رُسُلٍ مِّن قَبْلِكَ فَصَبَرُوا عَلَى مَا كُذِّبُوا وَأُوذُوا. Prophet Muhammad, prophets have been disbelieved before you, and they all were patient on that which they were disbelieved on, and rather they were harmed. Allah says about Nabiullah Ayyub, إِنَّا وَجَدْنَاهُ صَابِرًا نِعْمَ الْعَبْدُ إِنَّهُ أَوَّابٌ. We found Ayyub to be patient. What a righteous slave he was. إِنَّهُ أَوَّابٌ, he was one who ran to his Lord. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said about Nabiullah Ya'qub, فَصَبْرٌ جَمِيلٌ وَاللَّهُ الْمُسْتَعَانُ عَلَى مَا تَصِفُونَ. And Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, he said about the righteous people, إِنَّ الْمُسْلِمِينَ وَالْمُسْلِمَاتِ وَالْمُؤْمِنِينَ وَالْمُؤْمِنَاتِ وَالْقَانِتِينَ وَالْقَانِتَاتِ وَالصَّادِقِينَ وَالصَّادِقَاتِ وَالصَّابِرِينَ وَالصَّابِرَاتِ. Until he said subhanahu wa ta'ala, أَعَدَّ اللَّهُ لَهُمْ مَغْفِرَةً وَأَجْرًا عَظِيمًا. Those who have been mentioned, Allah has prepared for them forgiveness and great reward. So from amongst those were what? وَالصَّابِرِينَ وَالصَّابِرَاتِ. And Imam Ahmad ibn Hanbal and Shaykh al-Islam ibn Taymiyyah followed him on this. He mentions in his Majmu' al-Fatawa, the 10th volume, page 39, and Ibn al-Qayyim mentions it in his kitab, عِدَّةُ الصَّابِرِينَ وَدَخِيرَةُ الشَّاكِرِينَ. He says, Ibn Taymiyyah, and Imam Ahmad said it before him, and Ibn al-Qayyim also said it. He said, لَقَدْ ذَكَرَ اللَّهُ الصَّبْرَ فِي كِتَابِهِ. Allah has mentioned patience in his book, في أكثر من تسعين موضعا, in more than 70 places in his book. So my brothers and sisters, وهذا إن دل فإنما يدل على شرف الصبر ومكانته. If that shows and indicates something, then verily that indicates the honor of patience and its position. Last but not least, one is never going to gain leadership in this religion. بل لا تنال الإمامة في الدين إلا بالصبر واليقين. One will not gain leadership in the religion except through patience and certainty. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran, وَجَعَلْنَا مِنْهُمْ أَئِمَّةً يَهْدُونَ بِأَمْرِنَا لَمَّا صَبَرُوا وَكَانُوا بِآيَاتِنَا يُوقِنُونَ. We made them leaders who guide to our affairs when they became patient. Allah said that He made them leaders when they became patient and when they were, وَكَانُوا بِآيَاتِنَا يُوقِنُونَ, they were certain about our affairs and our verses. So my brothers and sisters, talking about patience and the ayat that have come regarding patience in the Quran, حديث طويل جميل بطول الصبر وجماله وجلاله. There are many evidences, extensive evidences, so we won't be able to cover it all in this sit. But this is just some of it. My brothers and sisters, patient linguistically means الحبس والمنع. It's to imprison and it's to prevent. اصطلاحا, and technically it means is to imprison your soul, your nafs, from stress and anger, to also imprison your tongue from complaining, and to imprison your limbs from sinning. So this indicates to us, my brothers and sisters, that patience is a methodology. Patience is a religion. It's not just words that one utters on his tongue. لَيْسَ مُجَرَّدُ كَلِمَةٍ يُرَدِّدُهَا مُبْتَلَى. It's not just words that the one who is suffering just repeats and regurgitates. And the patience, my brothers and sisters, it has to be done at the first stages of when the calamity befalls you. The Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said in the hadith, Imam al-Bukhari narrated and Muslim, إِنَّمَا الصَّبْرُ عِنْدَ صَدْمَةِ الْأُولَى. Verily patience is at the first moment of when the affliction hits you. And that is the reality of patience, that you do it at the first moment. My brothers and sisters, patience is of types. The first type is sabrun ala ta'ati Allah, to be patient upon the obedience of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, or to be patient upon that which Allah has commanded you subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's the first type. To be patient on that which Allah tabarak wa ta'ala commanded you, and the obedience of Allah, is to do everything that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala told you that seems hard for the nafs of the person. Because as we all know, our nafs is inclined to evil, and it will call us to evil. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said in the Quran, إِنَّ النَّفْسَ لَأَمَّارَةٌ بِالسُّوءِ إِلَّا مَا رَحِمَ رَبِّي إِنَّ رَبِّي غَفُورٌ رَحِيمٌ. That the nafs is one that calls to evil, except that which Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has mercy on. The second type, which is صَبْرٌ عَنِ الْمَعْصِيَةِ, to be patient from sins. In other words, صَبْرٌ عَنِ الْمَحْذُورِ, to be patient from the prohibited things. And that involves to stay away from eating that which is haram, to stay away from the fitan, the trials and the tribulations, to stay away from al-ghiba, backbiting, and namima, and the likes of that. The third type, which is sabrun ala al-bala, or sabrun ala al-maqdur, to be patient upon the harm that you are afflicted, the suffering which you endure, to be patient on it. And to always remember the statement of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, إِنَّا كُلَّ شَيْءٍ خَلَقَنَاهُ بِقَدَرٍ. That Allah says that we have created everything based on a destiny and on a qadr. وَقَالَ جَلَّ وَعَلَىٰ, and Allah also says, أَلِفْ لَا مِيمْ أحسب الناس أن يتركوا أن يقولوا آمنا وهم لا يفتنون ولقد فتن الذين من قبلهم فليعلمن الله الذين صدقوا وليعلمن الكاذبين. Did the people think and assume that they will be left to say, oh, I believe, and they're not going to be tested? Allah tabarak wa ta'ala, he has tested those who have come before you. So a test is going to come. And through that test, it will become clear the one who is truthful and the one who is lying. The one who is truthful about his belief and the one who is lying about it. Those three types of patience is all compiled in one verse of the Quran. Those three types of patience, all of them, you will find them in one verse, Surah Al-Luqman. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he says, Ya bunayya aqimi as-salata wa'mur bil ma'rufi. That's the first type. Oh my son, Luqman says, establish the prayer and call to the good. Wanha 'anil munkari, and stay away from and prohibit the evil. Stay away from it yourself, and of course, prohibit others. وَاصْبِرْ عَلَى مَا أَصَابَكَ, and then be patient on that which you are afflicted with. So the first type is الصبر على طاعة الله. يا بني أقم الصلاة وأمر بالمعروف is الصبر على طاعة الله. وانهى عن المنكر is صبر عن المعصية. And the third, which is واصبر على ما أصابك is صبر على المقدور. And those are the three types. Allah تبارك وتعالى, He tests. And the test of Allah تبارك وتعالى is categorized into two. الابتلاء بالشر, Allah سبحانه وتعالى, He tests you with evil. Allah tests you with evil. And at that point, what is needed from you is patience. وهو مناط الصبر. And the second one, which is the second type, is that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He tests you with good. Allah tests you with good. And gratitude is what is needed from you. وهو مناط الشكر. And the hadith in Sahih Muslim, on the authority of Suhaib radiallahu ta'ala anhu, that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, عَجَبًا لِأَمْرِ الْمُؤْمِنِ إِنَّ أَمْرَهُ كُلَّهُ خَيْرٌ وَلَيْسَ ذَلِكَ إِلَّا أَحَدٍ إِلَّا لِلْمُؤْمِنِ إِنْ أَصَابَتْهُ صَرَّاءَ شَكَرَ فَكَانَ خَيْرًا لَهُ وَإِنْ أَصَابَتْهُ ضَرَّاءَ وَإِنْ أَصَابَتْهُ ضَرَّاءُ صَبَرَ فَكَانَ خَيْرًا لَهُ. Amazement is to the affairs of the believer. All of his affairs is good. And that is for nobody else except the believer. If good comes his way and he has been tested with good, he shows gratitude and it's good for him. And if he's tested with harm and evil, he is patient and that is good for him. So the believer's affairs does not leave those two. He is either going through hardship and he comes with patience, or he's enjoying himself and he comes with gratitude. The da'i who's giving da'wah and is calling to the path of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he should have with himself patience. أن يكون صابرا على دعوته مستمرا فيها صابرا على ما يعترض دعوته. Patient upon that which he goes through in the course of his da'wah, the people's harm. And the da'i needs to remember that the people are going to hate him and they're not going to show appreciation to him. And the reason for that is because he is one who is tackling the people from them following their whims and their desires. من شهواتهم ورغباتهم وعادات أقوامهم, and the norms and the culture of their people. He is an obstacle between them and their desires, and them following their cultural principles that oppose the Kitab and the Sunnah, he is the one that is standing in between them and it. So the majority of the people don't like that. And they will fight and show enmity to that person. So he needs to remember, he has to come with this valuable quality, which is الصبر على الأذى فيه, patient upon the harm that comes to you from the people. I will conclude there inshallah ta'ala for this sit and lesson. سبحانك اللهم بحمدك أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أستغفرك وأتوب إليه.